Fuel is a significant one in humans' life. The world cannot run without fuel. Unfortunately, we are going to run out of fuel in a very short time. So we are in a situation to find out an alternate promised fuel. Biomass-based fuels are quite attractive due to its abundant availability, carbon neutral, reducing greenhouse gases, environmental friendly, and sustainable development of mankind. Okay, here we go. Now we are standing in front of Sardar Swaran Singh National Institute of Bioenergy. It is an autonomous institution of the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, Government of India, located in Kapurthala district of Punjab. It is an ISO certified R&D institution with its vision to develop innovative technologies in the area of bioenergy. Founded in 1998 and functionalized in 2009, the institute has mandate to develop postdoctoral research and research leading to commercialization of renewable energy technology. SSS NIBE is the India's leading research and development center for biofuel with the state-of-the-art laboratories. In biofuel research, India's achievement is a significant one because of SSS NIBE. Let's have a look what is really going on inside. The entire campus covers an area of 75 acres of land with conspicuous floral and energy plantations including 10,000 jatropha, 200 bamboo, 3,000 forestry and oil-bearing plants. R&D activities have been carried out in different areas of bioenergy, that is, biomass and energy management, conversion of biomass through thermochemical, biochemical and chemical routes, and electrochemical processes for producing electricity, including hybrid energy systems.
Our vision is to become an apex institution for carrying out the state of art, research and development activities in the field of bioenergy.
Our objective comprises of bioenergy, biofuel, and synthetic fuel in solid, liquid and gaseous form for transportation, portable and stationary application, as well as development of new technologies for effective utilization of different type of waste and production of value-added products.
We are actually promoting and creating facilities in all the emerging aspects of bioenergy to set up the pilot and demonstration plant. If that means a technology is being developed by some department or some agencies which can be scaled up to pilot scale level, that will take up and will give them funding, will do the entire, that means, demonstration plan here at SSS NIBE. Actually, like that, 1300 crore project we have already submitted to the Ministry of Finance and already it is cleared by the ministry. So if that money comes, we have one another vision to set up six similar type of needle type laboratories in different regions of the country to combine entire nation in the under the NIBE umbrella.
So this division basically focuses on the catalytic and non-catalytic conversion of different biomass feedstocks to value-added chemicals, fuels and materials. And we work on two different aspects, catalysis and products.
My project is on biomass conversion to value-added chemicals. Like I'm working on silica extraction from rice ash.
The electrochemical conversion division takes up activities in fuel cells, biofuel cells and electrocatalyzers. The basic idea here is to use the biofuels produced for biofuel applications under biochemical and chemical conversion division.
India has a mandate to blend 5% ethanol in gasoline and to fulfill this requirement, about 1.33 billion liters of ethanol is required. However, the last year supply of ethanol was only 0.82 million liters, which would fulfill only 2% of ethanol blending in gasoline. Moreover, to fulfill the targets of 20% ethanol blending by 2017 set by the Government of India, we require lignosulfosate-based ethanol. So for that, our institute is working in this direction to produce the biofuels, mainly ethanol, biobutanol, biogas, biohydrogen, and alcohol-based biofuels.
A thermophilic consortium has been developed for anaerobic digestion of lignocellulosic biomass. The consortium has the capability to utilize paddy straw in 10 to 12 days with high biogas yield and kitchen waste in 15 to 20 days with high yield of hydrogen and biomethane. Some algae species have also been isolated for power generation through algal fuel cell along with algal-based biofuels.
Further molecular modifications has been done to enhance the bioethanol production for the promising microorganisms.
Another SCRV funded project has been started to enhance the butanol tolerance of the bacteria for high production of butanol titrate.
The laboratory is equipped with instruments like bioreactor, lyophilizer, HPLC, gas chromatography, biospectrophotometer, fiber tech, and several molecular and microbiology lab equipments.
If we want to develop a cooking stove which is at par with the LPG in the form of emission and so, we need to have process fuel. This is one thing. Second thing is that for specific regions and specific need of the individual also, the device has to be modified accordingly. There are several places in India where we don't have the electricity. So we have to incorporate the TEG, thermoelectric generator, in the device so that it can produce electricity from the heating which is otherwise going waste from the cooking stove. And the technology is being developed by different laboratories, including IIT Delhi. We are slightly far behind, but we are working in that direction and we hope that we will be achieving that goal. That is one thing. In the future, the institute is having, you know, most of the important responsibilities, and we hope that our institute will do a good work in that aspect.
State-of-the-art facility has been created for testing and certification of the biomass cook stove with suspended particulate matter analyzer, multi-component gas analyzer, and other testing instruments. Studies have also been carried out for the development of technologies relating to thermal conversion of biomass and power generation, biomass pyrolysis and the performance evaluation of the systems and economic appraisal. A 10 kilowatt downdraft biomass gasifier has been installed. The institute has been recognized as the coordinating and managing entity for program of activity in improved cook stove. Characterization of biomass is carried out in the institute with CHNSO analyzer TGDTA, furnaces and bomb calorimeter and thermo-analytical techniques using differential scanning calorimeter.
Global level research, India is also stepping forward on research on biofuel. This is not as much easy as you think. There are miles to go. But in future, if you ever come to India, we'll be using biofuels instead of fossil fuels. And that time, NIIP will be proud of their current work.